Okay, back again with real money trades from my masterclass over at simpleswitch.teachable.com. If you go over there and take my masterclass, it will get you up to speed on what I'm doing with this real money trading series, growing a small account in the futures market and with swing trading. And I chose the futures market to go with this because I don't have to worry about the PDT rule and I can day trade. In my masterclass, I take you from day one to I want to be a trader, then selecting a broker, opening an account, then teaching you how I build winning strategies that fit you. So I call it the PLG, personality, lifestyle, and goals. But not just that, strategies that have a proven statistical probability of success. Once we build our strategies, then we build a trade plan to go with those strategies. Two completely different things, traders. You need a good strategy and a good trade plan to be successful. Then I sim trade those strategies, and now we're into the real money trading portion of building a winning strategy. That is what this series is about. I plan on trading these accounts until the end of 2023, and we'll see how far we can grow them in 1 year's time. Now, I don't know if these strategies are going to be successful. We're going to find this out together. And if they're not, hopefully I can tweak them along the way to make them successful. I started my futures account with $1,700 because that was the bare minimum I felt like I could start with. And then I started my swing trading account with $2,000. Again, I felt that was the bare minimum I can start with. In my masterclass, I explain all these details and why I make the decisions, what you're seeing on the screens, the charts that you're seeing, all the tools, all that stuff. This class can benefit beginner traders and pro traders alike. I do trade with my algorithm, but you don't need that in order to benefit from my masterclass. You can trade with whatever tool it is for you. If you're thinking about taking somebody else's class, my masterclass can help you choose what other strategy might be right for you. This way, if you're going to spend a lot of money to buy somebody else's strategy, it would really be good if that strategy would fit you. And I teach you all about that in my masterclass, so go check it out. But for now, let's get into today's video. All right, so here we are, Real Money Trades, continued from the simpleswitch.teachable.com education. So this might be the end. Yep, this just might be the end. So this week, took a few trades. I didn't take every trade I should have taken or could have taken. And I really screwed up one trade a lot, big time. Like going from green with bonus money to red with a debit. So anyway, is what it is. Let me show you the trades and then we'll look at the My Strategy Manager and tell you what's going on. Okay, so here we are back with that trade. It's taken a long time to for this trade to complete. You know, got in way back here, took over a day and a half. Now we're here, I got my alert telling me that it's pushed down through to my target. I was giving myself some room so I could squeeze more out. So this is how I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna take this up here, this stop. I'm gonna drag it down so I can get to it. And then I'm gonna go ahead and start to trail it. I wanna put it to my location where I wanted to get out, which is right here. So now I've locked in profit. So now I can do a couple things to trail it. I can just pull this down here some more. You know, I was looking for $200 on this thing and I'm at 250. I could just take it off the table right here and say, hey, bonus money if I want to. Or I can pull it down and slowly trail it that way. Or I can leave it and then wait for this candle to close and just leave it. And when the next candle closes red, then start to trail the tops of every red candle. So I could do it that way as well. So there's lots of ways I can do it, or I can let it hit 2R and just move it really tight. You know, whatever works for you based on, you know, what you've got a proven probability with, whatever fits your personality, lifestyle, and goals, your trade plan, all that good stuff is what you kind of do. But for me, it's random. It's based on, you know, what's happening in the market, that ticker, how I'm feeling, whatever. It doesn't matter because I've already got my target. So everything else is just bonus money. So I'll let this thing run a little bit and then we'll see how much we can get out of it. One thing to keep in mind though, is that if this candle was going to be closing, like it's a 4 hour candle. So if this was going to be closing like in the next half an hour, maybe even hour, chances are it's going to create a tail, right? A tail or a wick, depending on where it's at. See most of the candles before it. So that means it's probably going to back up. So if this was going to be closing soon, I'd be trailing a really tight stop. If it backed up, you know, I got my bonus money. But we got quite a bit of maybe 3 hours left on this candle. So there's a good possibility. And it's breaking this support. You can kind of see the support area. It really needs to get down in here to 3462 to really break it and start to move, which is way down here. But that could also be a draw for this to get pulled down to that support level. So there's a good possibility I'll be able to get a lot more out of this. What I am going to do is I just kind of want to know visually when I'm looking at the chart, where am I doubling my, where am I making a 2-to-1 on this thing, right? So I'm going to put this here so that I know that that is my 2-to-1. I'm going to gray it out so it's not distracting from where the, it doesn't look like a second trade setup. And there we go. So that's my 2-to-1. I'm going to change that red line to a green line. So once we get to 2-to-1, I definitely want to start to trail a bit of a tight stop with this one, because if I can get 2 out of it, then I've basically, I put one in the bank to pay for losers, right? Got my winner, scaling ladder, put one in the bank to pay for losers. That'll be pretty nice. So especially since we just started this new system last week, it'd be nice to get that extra cushion in there. It's tempting to take it right now though, right? An extra almost $86. Just percentage wise, that's huge. So yeah, but we're gonna let this thing, I'm gonna let this thing keep on playing out. Thinking about go ahead and move my stop down here and take this profit off real soon. Looking at the 5-minute candle right now as well, my other monitor, we had a big candle that's retracing. We'll see if it wants to dip back down in here. And then it may start trailing those 5-minute candles. Let me do that right now, actually. And then if it wants to keep on going, I'll keep trailing the 5-minute candles. Let's go there real quick and look at it. 5-minute. Look at that. Look at that slide. So right now, we just had this big candle. It's getting rejected. It may turn green. This may be the sign of a bottom. And it may go sideways for a while. It may even rally back up. I'm going to go ahead and just put my stop right now, my trailing stop for a profit at the top of this 5-minute candle. And then if it does turn green, then that's a very bullish sign. So I'll be out of this trade for some nice bonus money. And if it wants to turn, go back down here red again and keep showing weakness, then I'll keep trailing the tops of the wicks of this 5-minute candle. Okay, so stop is at the top of that red candle. Let's see if this, I mean, we've got a lot of red here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? 2, 4, 6, 6 red candles. Green one's coming. Question is, will it break above the red candle? If it does, then I'm out of the trade. I'm fine with that. So I'm gonna trail the tops of the reds. We'll see what this one does. Okay, see how it went green and it went almost to the top of that candle. And I gave it a little room above the top just in case it wants to poke its head out above the top of here, but it retraced that candle and then came back down. Look at the candle before it. See how it's retraced? And then it came back down. Retraced some, came back down. Look at this one over here. See how it retraced? Almost to the top, came back down. So retracing candles before are pretty common. You know, this candle green retraced, came up, closed green, then went back down, right? And then up and down and whatever and all this stuff. But a lot of times they retrace each other. A lot of times candles, they don't always, like right here, didn't retrace this at all, but and didn't retrace there at all. But I know they retrace a lot, so I need to give them room for that retrace should that be what happens. Right here, this candle didn't retrace it, but then the next one retraced it, and then it went back down, right? So I got to give it some room for retrace, and then if it's going to break above and close above, it could be going to consolidation, could be turning around and rallying, you know, and it could be crashing. It could be a lot of things, but one thing is for sure is I don't know where it's going, so I'm happy to be out. All right, let's see if we get out. $300 would be awesome. All right, so out of the trade with $300, I think. Put it in my strategy manager. We'll see where we end up at when we review it. All right, buddy, see you on the next trade. All right, so back in the futures market with XC, corn futures. So as I told you before in other videos, not all futures contracts trade at the same time. You know, like when the MES reopens at 6, some stuff doesn't reopen at 6. When the MES closes at 4, some stuff, or 5, whatever, some stuff's already closed. So it all depends on the futures contract, what they're doing. So they're different. So just be aware of that. It's not, you know, the futures hours, normally we say it's like 6 to 4 or 6 to 5. But it does not that way for everything. So this triggered a long trade right here in this candle. But so once that candle closed, I wasn't here to be able to get in on the close of the candle. And I wanted to get in on the open, but I didn't want to miss the opportunity. So when the futures markets close with Thinkorswim, I can't put orders in. So I'm just going to put this on here to see where I got in. 476, right click, and then I can just change it here.
and get the 575, get the exact spot. Wow, got it way up here. All right, so it's too bad. So I can't write at the top of that, and then it's sold off. Man. So I can't put orders in when the futures contract is closed. I got to wait for that to start trading again to open up. Or at least I can't put market orders in. Normally with like equities, I can put market order in, and as soon as the market opens, it'll get me in at that price. Can't do that in the futures market with Thinkorswim. I have to come over and put a limit order in to buy my position. So I put it just above where the ladder was showing the price. And then that's where I got in, ended up being up kind of up here a little bit. So it's kind of a bummer, but I'm going to mark it up real quick and then, talk some more. Okay. So there's my trade right there. So I'm going to put my OCO order in. The OCO order lets me put my order in, and then it'll automatically, you know, if I get stopped out, then the limit order will get taken off. You know, if my limit order gets filled, then my stop order will get taken off. It'll close out everything that's on the thing there. So let me put this in. So I'm in long, so I'm going to sell it to get out. All right, bring that up to the stop. It's kind of a little scary with this tower candle hanging out over here. Could see a retracement of that before it wants to go higher. But is what it is. If that's what happens, that's what happens. I'll be out of the trade. So, or maybe I'll speed bump it. All right, so the OCO order, I have a limit order and a stop here. If this comes down and hits my stop, then its limit order will disappear, so I don't have an open order. And if it comes up and hits the limit and I'll get out with my profit, then the stop will be gone, so I don't have an open order in there. If the limit order got hit and I got out of the trade for profit, then it sold off, this stop would end up selling me shares, or, you know, basically getting in short. And then I'd be in a trade I didn't want to be in. So that's the deal with OCO. It automatically cancels that out. All right, so that order's in. I'm going to go put that in the My Strategy Manager. I may switch this 5 to a 10 for a speed bump, and then I'll bring that conclusion to you. But before I do that, I want to show you one other trade. Okay, so here I am with Tesla. So again, going with the small account based on my scaling ladders and not risking more than 2% of my account on any one trade, et cetera, and so forth. I am in Tesla with one contract. It's kind of a big move. You know, we're talking, you know, 50 points or more that we're looking at. So it's a decent sized move. So it's a good chunk of change there. So for a small little, you know, account that's growing, if this was a huge account, of course I can get more, but we're growing a small account. So we got to be smart about it. So right now we're in with one contract, and that's with Tesla. I talked about it over the weekend, you know, with my thoughts on it, but you know, I'm going by the probabilities right now. This looks like it's got more downside ahead, maybe a gap that wants to fill a little more, stuff like that. So this thing could continue to sell off. But again, it's a swing trade. These are weekly candles, and this trade could be on for the next 2 months, you know, or a month or two, or whatever it is. So we'll just have to wait and see. It could be, you know, the next week this could hit the target. We have some big candles back here and going back. So it's possible that it can move in the next couple of weeks. But one contract in, and we'll see how Tesla does. Okay, so back with that trade XC. Woke up to some money. Last night it hits target right here, probably around between 1 and 5 in the morning. And I was a little worried about it with this tower candle. I was like, this thing might retrace and get me out. I did add a contract right here in this candle. And then, you know, I was like, well, it is what it is. I got to play the statistics, right? I got a proven statistical probability of success. I just have to go with that. And yeah, there we go. Nice little winner. All right, bring the next trade to you. All right, so here we're back in the futures market on September 20th with MGC. So I just had a reset right here on Sniper, so I could jump in the trade. Tower candles are okay. Double check my rules and MGC. I'm not supposed to trade the candle that sets up at 9 a.m. So that's like the one rule with MGC. Don't trade the candle that sets up at 9 a.m. If anything, trade the opposite of that candle is what the rules say. So now I'm in a trade I'm not supposed to be in. So I need to get out, although it's already going up a little bit. And most candles on a lot of tickers and MGC, they like to make little wicks and tails, right? Wicks and tails. We don't have a very good wick yet, although it's one's creating. We're at $8 right now. So I'm going to go ahead and move my stop up and try to capture, you know, $8 to $10. I got two contracts, so commission's going to be $10. If I can make $10 in this trade, then I'm good to go. I'll make commissions. But if I take a small loss in the trade, then I take a small loss. So I'm going to trail this stop real tight. And if I get out and it runs without me, I get out and it runs without me. And it is what it is. You know, I miss out on a nice winner. But it's a casino trade right now because I'm not supposed to be in this trade. So I need to be smart about it and just trade the plan, you know. And if I don't like my plan, then I need to change my plan, test it, and then trade that plan. So let me try to get out of this trade. And then I did get into another trade. And what I probably will do if the opportunity presents itself is I'll roll over the money from this, that you know, the available funds for trading on this, over to that other trade. Let's see here. We got, all right. So now we're right there. So tight stop. If I get out, I should be close to break even. Maybe I'll lose a couple bucks in commissions. You know, it'd be a green trade as far as the trade goes, but commissions wise could take a small loss. Let's see if I can move this up one more time. All right, now I don't think I'll take any losses. I think, yep, we'll be break even. If I can move this to right here, that'd be awesome. Come on, MGC, boost a little bit for me. Get a little pop. Pop off the top. A little pop off the top. All right, cool. So we're out $8. I'll take a $2 loss in commissions. I'll put that in the My Strategy Manager, and then we'll look at it all together at the end of the week. Let's go look at that other trade now. Okay, so here we are with the XW, which is wheat futures. So I'm going to go ahead now and I'm going to short this. I have two contracts available because of the funds that are now available from the MGC trade that just closed out. This is my entry that I'm in it right now. And I may add two more contracts here if this wants to come back down. But I want it to come back down and get me in just in case this is going to continue going higher. I'd rather get a bigger discount. So I'm going to let that come back down right now and then we'll wait to get in. And then I'll put my OCO order in. I'm going to put my stop just above the top of this candle, just in case there is a retrace of this candle. I'm going to go ahead and put my stop right there at the top of it and just give it a little bit of breathing room there. But yeah, a nice retrace of the bottom of this candle, this support area would be nice. Come in and make some money on that right there. Yeah, so you can see my chart is showing my trades. That's where I got in those two contracts right there. And you don't see any trades right here. So I was able to avoid this loser. This candle started at basically 10 o'clock, finished at 1 o'clock is when I would have had to jump into the trade. I'm in bed, so no can do, and missed out on anything, got lucky, and didn't take a loser. So it's pretty nice that there was a loser right here because that makes this trade a much higher probability. So I got to avoid the loser and hopefully get to take advantage of the high probability winner. But this could be a loser as well. There are more than one loser in a row. Let's see what do we got here, right? I got like three in a row right there. So we could have more than one in a row, but it's not, let me shrink this. It's not common. So losers two in a row right there. Speed bumps would have paid off. That's what those green, this light white or kind of teal dot is. It's telling me that speed bumps would have paid off. Speed bump. And that's why we have multiple losers here too, speed bump wise. So trade, speed bump, and then, trade. Yeah. Why do we have a red dot there, actually? There's no trade here. Why did I do that? Reset. Oh, reset right here. For okay, so yeah. So trade. If I muddy up my chart, this was the trade right here. So that would have been a loser as well. So yeah, three losers there. Speed bump would have worked out there. Speed bump would have worked out here. Speed bump would have worked out there. So speed bump would have been awesome. And then over here, those two trades, speed bumps would have been fantastic. So two in a row, single, right? Single, and speed bumps would have been awesome on all of these. So it's not often that we have multiple losers. All right, so let's go back to where we were. So this is a loser, and the speed bump would have paid as well right there. So speed bumps are great. Okay, so this is moving up some. So now I can start to trail an entry a little bit and get in a bit of a discount. So my entry's right there. So that'll give me a little discount. I'll take it. And again, if worst case scenario happens and I take a loss on this trade, I'll speed bump it. And hopefully that speed bump will be a winner. But here's the thing. We're off to a really good winning streak, which means a loser's coming. And I have to accept that, you know. Loser's coming. And when it gets here, I can be happy I got it out of the way. Moving on to more winning streaks, right? So yeah, we'll see if this trade hat sets up and we can get into it with some more contracts, or am I going to take a loss here? We'll see. So while I'm waiting for this, I'm going to put this to speed bump territory. I'm in short, so I'd be buying it back, I'm going to put my stop in just in case this boosts for some reason. Who knows, with news or whatever, you never know. And I want it to break this candle. So now I got my speed bump in right there. And then if this thing goes quick, I can get stopped out and get back into the long side. Okay, so there we go. So I'm in with my full lot size right now, 4 contracts. So I put that in my strategy manager. I'm going to switch. I'll leave that. Yeah, I'll switch it out. OCO. Okay, so I got my OCO order in. I got my 4 contracts down here to get out as my stop. My 6, which I'm going to actually change to 8. My 8 contracts up here to speed bump this. And then I put an alert in. If it gets down here, I kind of want to know about it. And then, so there you go. Trade is in. Bring the conclusion to you. Okay, so I was a dum-dum this morning. We're back with that trade with XW, right? So I was sitting here at the computer. I put an alert in for when it got close to the target, and I put my limit order way down here and went to make breakfast, but I left my phone in the office. So this came down, hit the alert, and I didn't know about it because my phone wasn't with me. So I came back to check and clearly hit the target for what would be a full profit, nice win, $200 or so. But I came back and saw this. So now what do I do? Do I just get out with my $132 and say, you know, it is what it is? Or do I wait for it to hit the target again? Well, I don't have a proven statistical probability that it's going to hit the target again. It already hit the target. And if I look at the chart, this isn't a support area, right? So I blew it on this trade. You know, nice winner. And if I don't capitalize on the winners, I'm not going to have the funds to pay for the losers. And then I slowly blow up the account. But what I am going to do is I'm going to at least move my stop right now. I'm short, so I'm buying to get it back or to get out of the trade to basically a break even trade. So now this wants to rally back up, retrace this red candle. I'm out of the trade, and it is what it is. So I'm going to give it a chance to do that, though, and see if we want to break a new low here. It did hit this and get rejected pretty hard. So anything can happen right now. All right, so very, very frustrating to get stopped out of this trade for a loss. Again, P&L day, don't pay attention to that. I'm gonna take that off, actually. Let's do that right now. All right, so yeah, so annoying. So full winner. Boosted right through there. Had I had my phone with me, I could have run in here and capitalized and made over $200 in this trade. But instead, because I was a dumb, I ended up with a red trade. I put that stop in because I don't have a proven statistical probability of success from here forward. So probably should have just got out with my $130, $140 that I saw when I could have got out there. It would have been growing my account still. But I was hoping that it's just a little retrace and it would go back down. Again, hoping with zero probabilities to go with my hoping. So I should have took my trade off the table, but I didn't. I put that stop and moved my stop down to basically break even. So as far as the trade goes, it's $18 in profit. But after commission, it's $1.20 loss. And now we see it coming back down again. So, yeah, you know, very... very frustrating here. So let me take you over to that MGC trade and show you what happened there. Okay, so here at that MGC trade, man, I'm going to be burned up all day long about that. If I take a loss, not a big deal, but I'm still bummed out about it if I take a loss. Even if I had 100 winners and I take one loss, I'm still bummed out about it a little bit. But when I have a nice winner and I take a loss, that's really frustrating. All right, so this was that MGC trade. I got in breaking the rules, remember, to the long side here. And it said I needed to get out, so because I don't have the probabilities, and I got out for a dollar loss or whatever, and I could have stayed in hoping that it would go up, but a good thing I didn't, right? Look at that, boom, would have been a big loser. But then we did have a trade to the short side set up right here at 1700, no problem. I could take this trade, tower candles, all good with MGC, and I had all my eggs in one basket, so I wasn't able to take this trade, and that was all in that. That trade that you just saw where I didn't get out at the target and didn't take the profit and took a loss. So not only did I miss out on a winner with that one trade, I also missed out on this trade. And then let me
one more thing I'll show you.
Okay, so here I am in the My Strategy Manager. So MYM was a trade that I was in last week on Friday. I closed actually on this this week right here. So that would have been, you know, $296 on the week to start, plus that $130 that I made on XC. So $224, $25, we'll just round it and say $225 on is how my week would have started, which would have been awesome. Sorry, $325 is how my week would have started, roughly. And then today would have been another $200 and change. I would have been around $500 for the week. So pretty good. With 2 days left, you know, we could have had, you know, $700 a week, $800 a week this week, which would have been fantastic. So because I screwed that up, it's put me in a harder spot. But at least I'm going to be green on the week. So that's something to think about. And then scaling ladders and the conservative ladder, you know, still in the $200 range. So it would have been right on target for that, which would have been awesome. And then over on dashboard would have been more awesome, or it is still pretty good. Started this account with $3,700 between swing trading and futures market, and then doubled the swing trading account. So down here, started that with $2,000 and it made $4,173 is where we're at now in the swing trading account, which is fantastic. And then the futures market started with $1,700 and I'm at $3,452. So I have doubled my futures account. So mission accomplished. The goal of this whole series was to double my accounts. So double the combined account total and basically make sure that I had doubled the futures account and the swing trading account and that not just one account carried the whole thing. So mission accomplished with this series. So traders, if you have a proven statistical probability of success, if you have a solid trade plan that fits your personality, your lifestyle, and your goals, and you have a strategy that's built around your trade plan, you can be successful in the market. Not everybody will. Some people just can't get it together. But those of you who can actually get it together, have a solid trade plan, a solid strategy that fits your plan, your personality, your lifestyles, your goals, you have a proven statistical probability of success based on solid data, a data set that's not really changing that much or not at all. And then what is your plan and your strategy based on? Is it trading every available trade or is it trading every Monday? You know, what is the frequency and what is it based on? And does that fit you? Can you actually accomplish that? Again, I don't think it's a good idea to buy other people's strategies unless it fits you 100%. But here's the thing. If you don't know how to build a strategy, a proper strategy, proper trade plan, if you don't know how to do those things, then what happens when that strategy starts to slip? Are you monitoring that strategy so that you can see when it's starting to slip? And then how do you modify it so that it can stay relevant? If you don't know how to do all that stuff, what's the point, right? Because every strategy is eventually going to see rough times and it may not recover. So you need to be able to identify that, modify it if that's what's needed and be able to keep going. So I think it's better for you to build your own strategy that fits you. It's not that hard to do it if you know what you're doing. And I teach you all that over at simpleswitch.teachable.com. For those of you who already took my masterclass and you were going through this entire video series to see the reality of trading, I'm hoping what all of you got from this was trading is not that easy. I mean, it's like, why is it so hard when it's easy? It's not as easy as it looks. I mean, you have to do work. You have to be able to monitor your stuff. You have to be able to reflect on things. You have to be able to you know, change things, adjust, adapt, all those kind of things in the trading market based on what's happening. And I'm hoping what you captured from this series, and I know it was long, was that, you know, just because you built a winning strategy in the sim doesn't mean it's going to be like that when you start trading with real money. You know, you saw I started out great on a hot streak, growing the account, and then almost blew the account up, then had to make adjustments, modify everything, modify the strategies, modify blah blah blah, start getting the account going again, and I did, and I grew it all the way back up again. But then I was running into problems because I wasn't taking every available trade, so I had to get lucky. And then I just wasn't trading because it wasn't convenient for me. I was doing other things and I didn't want to be captive. And, you know, I had to reassess my personality, my lifestyle, and my goals at that time. I'm traveling a lot, like all this stuff. you know, is my trade plan still valid? And it wasn't. So then I had to change it again and putting it into the 4-hour candle only, sniper only. Easy. I trade like 5 minutes a day right now. It's easy. I've got plenty of time to do other things. It makes it, you know, it makes trading a more doable thing for me without sacrificing a bunch of time. I don't want a full-time job doing this. You know, I want to be able to do this as little time as possible and still make money. So, and then you can see the last 2 weeks, you know, successful weeks. This week could be a lot more successful if I wasn't a dum-dum, but still successful weeks and growing the account, doubling it up. And just all I have to do now is just keep repeating the process, keep monitoring my trades. I use my Strategy Manager right now in September. You know, September's a good month, $1,700 in September. It's pretty fantastic. So, you know, I use this whole thing. I have trade calculators on here that can help me quickly determine my risk and all that stuff as well. Like, I have lots of tools on here that help me out, you know, with my setup. Like going up to the top here, I'll just go the easy way back to top. Let's go over and let's take a peek. This is the conservative account. So I'm going to hit refresh chart. This is my statistics. Let's look and see where we're at now. Since we've doubled the account, let's see what's up. So MES right now, we're trading with speed bumps. Wow, 75% success. That's pretty awesome. But I can come over here and see what tickers are working for me. So MCL, pretty good. 70%, not great, but not terrible. MES, 67%. And this is an aggregate from beginning to now. And right, you know, remember when I started to blow up my account, that's going to affect these numbers big time. So, and the biggest thing, I'll wait till we get to the end of it. So MGC, we're looking at 56%. Oof. And then MYM so far, 100% winning. I think we had some losers. You need to have a couple losers in order for the thing to start to calculate that. So, but basically MYM, we're 100% right now. XC, 100% right now. XW, 100% right now. So those tickers are doing good, but, you know, I'm going to have losers coming in them. But the biggest thing is, you know, with these tickers, I can look at it and say, MES, 80% success rate. And what's the reality? 67%. You know, I could say 75% success rate. What was the reality? 67%. So if I started with a reality of like 60% win rate or a, you know, practiced, back tested, sim traded 70%, my reality might be down in the 50% range or less. Hard to make money like that. So that's so those are the tickers, you know. MCL set showing reality of 70%. It's not great. Not great at all. But did I double my account with those? Yeah, I did. But the reason why was because I started out with a starting success rate much higher, which allowed me to, you know, in reality, not trade that well. Why are these numbers so low? Because I didn't take every available trade. Had I taken every available trade, these numbers would be a lot better. But I didn't, because my trade plan didn't really fit my lifestyle and goals. You know, it fit my goals, didn't fit my lifestyle. So I needed to readjust that. So that's the biggest reason. And then some of it was strategy starting to slip as well. So you combine all these little things, they all add up to blown up account at the end of the day if you're not monitoring it. So down, and I showed you in that one video, I was able to come in here, click on my stats and be like, whoa, these aren't good. Why? And we went through the whole process of like making adjustments, right? So strategies, casino trading, 57%, doing pretty good with casino trading, basically just guessing. And then my ladder strategy, we took a couple trades in there, I guess 50-50. RG, I got to fix this. So sometimes if I put it in the my strategy manager, and one of them has a space, another one doesn't, then it'll show up as two different strategies, but it's the same. So the one that's 50-50 is probably the reason why I'm seeing that, or 100%. So 50-50 in RG, it's terrible, right? Unless your winners are huge compared to your losers, RG 50. So RG is like full, like a lot more rules. And I did worse. Less rules, 63% on RG 50. And then even more less rules, we're looking at 87%. So, you know, I restricted myself so much in those trades that I was somehow doing worse. So, but with RG 70, pretty awesome. 87% success rate. That's exactly where I want to be. So sipper is supposed to be sniper, but somewhere I spelled it wrong. So on that one trade, that's why that's there. But it was a green trade. So I need to fix that so it can more accurately add to these statistics. So 72% with sniper, and that should get a lot better now with these other tickers that are doing awesome, and also adjust the rules a little bit to better fit what's happening in the market. Sonar, we took, I think, one trade as a winner. Oh, no, it was a loser. See down here? Loser, a loss. Even though it's blue, it was a loss. RG50 was win. RG, what was this one? That was a loss. So once I get those sorted out, that'll help my statistics balance out a little better. But basically, pretty close. 87% RG70 is awesome. Speed bumping, 67%. You know, those are winning numbers. So if I come over here and I can look and see, you know, well, let's go. And what was it? MES 67%. Okay, MES 67%. Let's click on MES and see what strategies were hurting me. So casino trading. The only casino trade I had in there was a loser. RG50. I can look down here and see that RG50 wasn't too bad. 63%. I mean, it's terrible, really. If you look at my video, 60 to 70% win rate, but it's still winning, I guess. Still success. RG70 was my best so far with MES. And then Sniper, 63%. And then Sonar, that one Sonar was a loss. And Speed Bumping, MES trades were 75%. So speed bumping my trades with it was awesome, and trading RG70 was fantastic. So if I wanted to stay with red light, green light on the 30-minute candle, I could, and I could start looking at dumping the rest of these, because they're just not that, they're dragging down this, right? All right, so MCL, casino trading, I did have one in there, and it was a win. Speed bumping MCL, 62%. It's not great to speed bump that, apparently. And let's see, what else do we have here with MCL? Sniper? No. So that's it for MCL. So MCL is just not too great. Speed bumping, that was the strategy that we were using for it. And it was 62% win rate. Not great. So dumped that ticker. As you can see, it's not in the lineup anymore, right? Because it's just not performing for me the way I want it to. MGC, looking at that, we have a casino trades with MGC. Had a few of them, and doing pretty good. 66% win rate on the casino trades. That's good for, you know, just taking a guess. On the ladder, not great. On RG, let's see. On Sniper, so far it's been, MGC's been great on Sniper, 100%. And then speed bumps, 61%, not great. But on Sniper, it's been great, you know, 100% so far. So we'll keep that. And as you can see, I dropped trading it with all these other things because they're just not performing in reality. So let's see, MYM, 100% so far. And that's the only way we've been trading MYM, XC, XW, and so forth. So far, so good. But you can see how statistics, I can use these to figure out what I want to stop doing, what I want to do more of, if I need to relook at things and stuff like that. So having a way to track what's happening with your trades and then being able to like process that data, you know, if you're just writing it all down in a book, sometimes it's kind of hard to process and really see the big picture, because you're looking at all these pages and you don't really want your eyes to like focus on what you want it to see and not focus on what you don't want it to see, kind of thing. You want to really see the accurate picture, and having tools that can give you that is really important. So my strategy manager is what I use to do that. And that's pretty much what's got me here where I need to be today, which is doubling this account. So mission accomplished in this video series. I'm going to end this video series here this week. And you know, I'll take a couple trades. If there anything sets up today, tomorrow, maybe I'll blow up my account. And this will be a different ending. But right now, this is where it looks like I'm going to end. I'll do a final conclusion for you at the end of the week. Okay, so here we are with the end of the week. So XW was the trade that I ended on for the week. I didn't take any more trades, but I do want to show you the charts so that you can see I didn't cherry pick my trades this week. You know the strategies, you know the tickers, and then I can show you what the charts actually look like so you can see that I didn't cherry pick, and I will start with XW. Okay, so these solid green lines here running vertical are showing you the week. That was the end of last week. This is the end of the week that we just were at. And you can see the trades. My trades are on the chart from Thinkorswim. And this is that trade. So I got stopped out here in this candle. Remember, it came back up. I got stopped out for a small loss after commissions. And then right after I got stopped out, it crashed way down. Man, what a bummer that was. So not only did I miss out on a winning trade with some bonus money, then I got stopped out for a loss, and then it fell down, and I could have made a lot more money. Had I just had my stop right on my entry price here, I would have been fine. I would have went for the ride, made a bunch of money, closed out the week awesome. And such a dumb, so frustrated about that. Anyway, that was the only trade I took with XW. Did not take this trade with XW right here, which was that loser. So that was a good thing. And then could have been a winner with a speed bump on it. I'm going to put a red ball on it and a speed bump ball just so I can mark it up. So when I'm looking back in the chart. Okay, so put my speed bump ball in there. That means it would have been a winning speed bump, red for the red trade. I'll do a purple ball if it's a losing speed bump, and then green for a winning trade. So when I'm going back through my charts, it's easy to look at. Right here is a green trade from last week. And this would have been a green trade, or it was a green trade, I should say. This would have been had I took it at 1 o'clock in the morning. And then we got all of our balls. So that makes it easy for me when I'm reviewing the charts. Okay, so let's look at the next one. So that was XW. Let's go look at MGC. Okay, so here with the MGC, again, inside the green lines is the week. Only trade that set up that met the rules. Remember, I took this one, which was a casino trade. Got lucky on that one and didn't take that big loss on it. Man, that would have been bad. But at the same time, I didn't take this winning trade either, which is also bad because if I'm not taking the winners, then I'm not capitalizing on the winners that I need to pay for the losers. And had I gotten out of my XW trade on the target, when it hit the target, I could have probably got into MGC here and made some money on it. There was plenty of opportunities to jump into this. So I could have, not only did I lose out on that 200 and change on XW, I lost out on another $200 on MGC. So really frustrating because I screwed up and left my phone in the office. Anyway, that's MGC. Let's look at the next one. Okay, here's XC, Corn Futures. So I took this trade, winner, nice. Got in right here. You can see not a tower candle. Tower candle defined by the dashes that are inside the candle, which indicate to me that a retrace is probable, but not high enough probability for me to want to trade it. Unless it fits the sonar strategy, which is something different. But anyway, so right here we had a tower candle, this red one right here. And you can see it sold off a little bit, then had that retrace, right? Tower candle right here, retrace up through the where my stop would be because my stop's on the dashes. So it kind of messed me up. So I try not to trade those on the tickers that don't support it. And this is one of those. So we got in right here, nice winner. And then the next, then we got a reset on the strategy right here. And then the next trade setup was here, but it was a tower candle, so no trade. So only one trade with XC this week. All right, next ticker. Here's MES. What a sell-off this week, right? And I wasn't a part of it because I don't trade tower candles on MES. So we got tower candle, and tower candle on all three of the indicators, like where it would have set up the short, right? This purple box right here, green to purple, short, inside the gray zone. Green to purple, inside the gray zone, short, right here. And but tower candles, so I can't do it. You know, if I would have did it here, I would have took a loss, right? So yeah, can't do it. And then if I would have did it here, I would have been an awesome winner, but the probabilities are not in my favor, so no trades. All right, next. Okay, here I am with the MYM. So this was that trade that started the following week that carried over to this week. That took forever to finally finish up, but made some money on that one. And then we went to green boxes right here, and then I reset for that short, going green to purple inside the gray. But it was on a tower candle, no trade. And then look at that big sell-off. Ah, I wish I was in that thing for that sell-off. But, you know, it is what it is. And here's the hard part about trading is you see this and you're like, oh, next time I'm going to do it. Even though the probabilities are not in your favor, you saw this, you wished out you were in it, you know, FOMO'd it, but you didn't get in. You're mad at yourself and you're like, next time I'm going to do it. And then next time you're going to lose all your money, right? So I just got to follow the strategy and the plan and plan the trade the plan kind of thing. And all this money was for somebody else to make. All good. I hope a bunch of you made a ton of money on this. And that's how it is. I'll wait for the next trade. All right, one more look and then we'll move on. Okay, this is a snapshot. This is what my monitor looks like. So you could see the MES, XW, XC, MGC, PL, which is not part of what we did, so I'm not showing those trades on here. Maybe I will in the future. And then MYM with a different series. MYM over here. So these are the five tickers that are being traded with Sniper right now. Not trading red light, green light, or anything else, just Sniper. Fits my personality, lifestyle, and goals much better right now. I only have to work about 2 to 3 minutes a day by doing that on the 4-hour candle. And it makes it a lot easier for me, and I could still meet all my financial goals and everything else. So that's the setup right now. And then whenever I want to make a trade, I see it setting up. I just come over to Thinkorswim and I hit maximize. And then I can come in, hit active trader, and do my trade. And then when I'm done with setting everything up, I can go back out and have my snapshot when I walk in my office. Every 4 hours, I can look in real quick and quickly see if anything is set up, walk back out, right? It takes me like a couple seconds. And if there's a trade, I just open this up real quick, active trader, put my trade in, OCO, and then bring it all back out and leave my office. So it's so much easier. I don't have to do nothing. It gives me so much more freedom than sitting here on a 5-minute candle watching like every minute that ticks by, you know, even the 30-minute candle. I just feel like every time I walk out, I'm coming back in. So 4-hour candle, much better. And the moves are bigger. That's the thing, traders. Like if on a 5-minute candle, the moves are small. So you make small money sometimes. On a 1-hour candle, it's bigger and bigger and bigger, right? 4-hour daily, weekly candle, the moves get exponentially bigger, which could exceed your loss ability, right? If you can only lose $500 and this moves 1,000 because it's on a weekly candle, then that's too much for you. You might have to be on a smaller time frame. But if you can afford to lose $100, that's like what your trade plan says, and the 4-hour candle supports that, then you know it's better for me to do it that way and spend less time on station. All right, everybody. So that's it. Double their money. This is the end of the Real Money series. That was continued from simpleswitch.teachable.com. I know it was long, but hopefully you got a lot out of it. You got to see the reality of trading for me anyway. You know, winning, losing, almost blowing up the account, having to revisit, get back in the zone, regrow the accounts, you know, all that stuff, stay focused. And then here we are doubling the accounts. So I will provide you with another video next week. We'll see what we're doing. Maybe I'll just continue this for a little while until October, which is when we started this whole thing a year ago. And I probably would have doubled my accounts in just maybe 4 or 5 months had I been able to trade my plan, but I wasn't able to. So I wasn't very successful as far as how fast I could double my accounts, which is the reality, right? A lot of times we do things because we see the dollar sign and it doesn't fit the reality of our lifestyle. So, and that's basically, you know, where I ended up, and the strategy started to fail. So I had to revise them to be able to keep on going and get back on green. So it took a little longer, but here we are, doubled up. And then I might just continue this, a few more videos, maybe in a different series playlist until the end of October. And then we'll move on to a new thing. All right, everybody. Good luck trading this week. Oh, almost forgot. One more thing. Here we are with Tesla. I almost forgot that short trade. And I owe you a short trade for this week. I want to try to show you. So Tesla right here. So Tesla's pulling back, filled that gap, headed towards the trend line. I'm going to add to my position now in Tesla. You know, I could only take one contract up here because, or one share up here because it's in the equities. The futures markets, contracts, equities, markets, shares. So Tesla, I took one share because that's all I can afford with my trade plan. And now that it's pulled back, I can afford another one. So I'm going to jump into Tesla with another share. And not because of the dollar amount, but because of the risk. You know, I do my risk management based on my share size, not where I put my stop. My stop is where the market wants it. So going to get another share of Tesla on Monday morning, and then we'll see how this trade sets up. I'm trading, swing trading on the weekly candle right now. So yeah, Tesla's in. And then let's look at a swing trade for this week, and then we'll close this video. I know it's long. I'm sorry. Almost done. Okay, so this week's swing trade that I'm looking at is SLV on the daily candle using my red light, green light setup. So right here, we can see we had a green trade. So basically, yeah, right here, I'm moving my stops to the support or resistance areas, not just on the red line for the algo, unless it's really far away. Then I'll use the red line on the algo. But if it's not too far away, I'm using using any kind of support or resistance or basic pivot from, you know, going new high, higher highs to higher lows kind of pivots as stops. So with that said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 winners. And 1, 2, 3. This is kind of a break-even trade. 3, so I don't count it. 4. 4 losers. So that gives me an 81% success rate that this trade right here will be a winner. The downside to it, though, is that I have 1, 2, 3, 4 winners in a row. So I already have a lot of winners in a row. So, yeah, kind of scary. But it is that there's a major support area right here. You can see this purple line. So we got a lot of support coming in there. It came back, got a lot more support, came back in, got a lot more support on its way back up. Does it finally come down and break this support? You know, the more time you hit it, the more chances of breaking. So this is the trade that I'm going to jump into on Monday. So I'm going to get into SLV here. Let's zoom in a little bit. Make this bigger. If you're on a small screen, easier to see. All right, so I'm jumping in at 21.58 is where I'm going to get in at, well, whatever the market open is on Monday morning. And then I'm going to put my stop down here at the support at 20.33 is where my stop's going to go, and I'm going to speed bump my trade. So if I speed bump my trade, for those of you who have gone through my school, know what I'm talking about and how it works. So for those of you who have gone to my school, you know how it works. So right here, I'll speed bump my trade. Just looking for a target right down here if I speed bump that trade. So just to recover a little bit of my loss, won't give me all of it back unless I get lucky and it breaks through and I could squeeze more out on the speed bump. But right now there's a trade. So it's SLV jumping in Monday morning right here at the around this level here. Might have a gap fill. It's possible. And looking for a target 22.41. Ideal entry around 21.58. And my stop is going to be 20.33 on SLV. So that's what I'm doing Monday morning with SLV. All right, everybody. See you on next week's video.